guys, hello from Nagaland. We just got here. I had a super early flight. I think we left home at about 4:30. But we are finally here after a long, long flight. The roads are a little bumpy, but we are super excited because we are here for the Hornbill Festival.
Finally reached the site of the Hornbill Festival, and we're super excited because it's been on our bucket list for ages now, forever. And I like the idea of it because it's basically an endeavor to revive the culture, the dying culture of Nagaland, and 16 tribes participate in it, and there's lots of dances
lots
and
of
partying and everything, and we'll take you along. Let's go. All right, so this is the village where the Hornbill Festival takes place, and it's set up specially for the Hornbill Festival. Guys, just a local kitchen, and the locals are cooking snails here. Cheers! The adventures are gonna begin. Beautiful the shop is. I'm in love with all these items. They have the most beautiful colors and jewelry here, and these are hairpins, but this is what I bought, so it goes around the bun. Look how pretty. Whenever Vid is lost, this is where you'll find him hiding and shooting in some tiny ass corner.
Guys, we are having way too much fun. This is so cool. Like, there's tug of war going on there. There is amazing cultural performances. So much color. The headgear is out of this world.
I actually bought something for myself as well. I'll show you soon. But you know, the best part, I mean, my personal favorite is that in places like Morocco and even Egypt, you know, I get really intimidated because people can be quite aggressive. And especially coming at the tourists. And here, everybody is just the opposite. They're a little shy, but they're so nice.
So accommodating.
And they're so,
so
welcoming. Yeah. And
it's
not, for money or tourism or anything. Yeah. They literally just, it's almost as if they're welcoming you to their home.
They want you to see
and,
the culture.
Yeah, they want you
beautiful.
To chat with them. It's really nice.
It's amazing. We can't wait to show you more. You know, we were at the festival all morning, and now we are going for lunch. The campsite actually packed lunch for us. We are going to have it in the middle of paddy fields here. I'll just show you the view.
But it's beautiful.
It's beautiful, and you know, we can't wait to go back to Hornbill Festival tomorrow. It was so much fun. We're going deeper and deeper into the fields. I can't see the guys. I've been too distracted taking photographs, but it's amazing. I mean, it's right in the valley. I won't call this a valley, but there's mountains all around. There's rice. Fields everywhere. They're a bit dry because it's winter, but beautiful.
Our camp packed lunch for us, so we're picnicking in the middle of the rice paddies. It's such a gorgeous view, and we're about to dig in. We have some Snickers. I can spy some Snickers, and I'm looking forward to that.
All are mine. Right, end of a long day, back to our tent. And this is something I remember from Ladakh as well. I used to look forward to the chocolates and the little stories about the little cultures. That's dark chocolate, I think. Ooh, I love it. What a long, long day. Long drive, bumpy drive. Hornbill, Zakama village, and an amazing dinner. So tomorrow is going to be even better because we're going back to Hornbill again. And we shoot some photos and videos around the campsite. So, see you tomorrow. All right, let me just take you to our tent, give you a very quick tent tour, if you may. It's beautiful in the middle of the wilderness. and let me just show you around. Right, so this one is ours. See the beautiful sunlight streaming through. This is our tent. Let's take you inside. Hey Savi, this is where you enter from. You know, it's crazy to think that these are mobile tents because these are the same ones in Ladakh, and then they moved them to Nagaland during Hornbill Festival. But look at the bed. It's beautiful. The view, all nature, very spacious. And this is the bathroom / shower room. Wow. Yeah, very comfortable. Heading off to Hornbill because we want to go talk to the tribes and just interact with them before the horde of tourists come here.
Yeah.
And after that, no fixed plans, but we'll see.
I think we just drive around.
Yeah.
And figure out what to do.
Some beautiful spots around here. So. Yeah.
Getting into the spirit of the Hornbill Festival in full flow. I bought this little head accessory. How beautiful is it? Basically, you tie it around your bun and I'm wearing it today. It's a Naga hair accessory, but it's just so beautiful.
Hey, meet Donveer. He is an amazing photographer. And
no.
this is the sweetest tribe that we have come across. Yesterday we were here and they were having lunch. So they offered us lunch and that's why I came here again this morning, greedy me. But beautiful people, beautiful. And always smiling, always laughing. What a location. You recognize that face, sir. Don't we? Thank you so much, my friend. It
most
was
welcome.
So good meeting you.
Come back again.
For sure. Hey, look, this is like music to my ears or stars to my eyes, but yeah, in dire need of an espresso, so I'm going to check this out. I've anyway heard so much about these guys. Let's see. That looks nice. So does the place. It's right here in the festival site. Tastes nice too. Oh, I'm getting a nice shot of espresso in the Hornbill Festival thing. Something to be grateful for. We had such a nice morning today. We went to the festival again, interacted with the tribes.
If you're going to the Hornbill, if you're coming to the Hornbill, then I would really, really recommend going early one morning.
Yeah.
Because in the evenings and in the afternoon, there's so much excitement in the air. But if you go early, you can actually interact with the tribes and talk to them, smile with them. It was really nice.
It was amazing. And now we are off to lunch. Super hungry. Skip breakfast. Have to look after the beautiful figure, you know. That's the dining area. Look, there is an espresso machine as well. Savi's already taken her seat. Someone's hungry. And Savi is having the Indian thali, which is like a sampling platter. She's ordered only 3 portions because she's not that hungry. There's a chicken, what's that, Savi?
I think it's bottle gourd.
Okay, and some dal. Go on, Savi. How is it?
Yummy. Really good. These are part of a really interesting ritual called the Feast of Mary, and it's one of the ways in which the community maintains a balance between the rich and the poor. So every time a person gets really rich, they can throw a feast for the village and then they can hang one of these heads in front of their house. Imagine how many feasts this person has thrown already.
Right, our last night here. and we are super sad to leave. But we are also going to try Naga food tonight, prepared by Master Chef Ake Toli. I hope I'm pronouncing the name correctly, otherwise she's going to hunt me down and kill me. Here it is, boiled greens, some fish, that's pork, that's dal, potatoes and beans, not interested, some more boiled vegetables and black rice, that's the Naga chili. I think I'll stay away from that because otherwise I'll be screaming. Let's see how that tastes. I'm going to try the pork first because everyone here just keeps talking about the pork, so it has to be pork. It's not as pungent as I thought it would be, but it's yummy.
Maybe they've tailored it to tourists' tastes.
It's yummy. Bye.